In Central Australia, Slick is late for a date.
Right, I left Perth Thursday night. It's now Sunday morning. We're about 800 from Alice Springs. I'm supposed to be in Alice Springs to unload tomorrow.
He's promised his wife he'll finish his delivery and be home for Christmas.
I'm going to be late, but hopefully not too late.
But that depends on his tyres holding out on a notorious desert track.
Last trip, I left Alice Springs with 9 spares in me racks, and I got home with no spares in me rack.
Slick has a dilemma. If he drives faster, he risks a blowout. Drive slower, and he could be a day late into Alice Springs.
Yeah, you going, Roscoe? Slick. Yeah, all right, mate. I'm just out from the rock, eh? Yeah, I know. Yeah, no, look, mate. First thing tomorrow morning. Gates open 7. If I'm not there by 7:30, you know, you might have to worry. Have a good night. It didn't go down too well.
With his wife and his customer watching the clock, pressure is mounting on Slick to make up the time.
I should have been in Alice Springs already, but there you go. Nothing you can do about it. Just seen something fly out on the left-hand mirror there, so I'm just going to pull up here and go and have a look and see what it is. What's going to happen? And there's me problem. One out tyre.
The tyre has overheated, expanded and exploded in the tough desert conditions.
Oh, yeah. It's taken out 2 tyres. When that one blew, it's taken out the side wall on this one. So I'm up for changing 2 of them now.
If Slick keeps shredding tyres at this rate, his chances of making Alice Springs on time are getting slimmer by the hour. With Christmas looming, Slick should have been in Alice Springs by now, unloaded the building supplies and on his way home to Perth.
There's the problem. He's got no rubber.
But he's stranded, 300 kilometres short of his destination.
End of the day, just when I thought I was going to be winding down, and then this happens. Come on. OK. Play that game. Been on the road 3.5 days and got 1 more hour to go and then we'll be in the yard.
Just after dawn, Slick finally makes the bitumen. He's desperate to make up lost time for one of his most important clients.
80 to 90% of our freight is from this company, so you give it time, try to make it. Generally, 99% of the time we are on time, but, well, maybe not 99% of the time. That's a little stretch of the truth there, but there you go.
Slick is aiming for a 7 a.m. arrival at the depot gate in Alice Springs.
It's good to get in here. 7:10. Beautiful. I'm about 14 hours later than what I normally come in, but they're all happy.
After a 5-day battle with some of the worst roads in Australia...
Everything's travelled okay.
The neatest man in trucking has only one thing on his mind.
I want to have a shower, mate. I haven't had a shower since I left.
A quick shower and Slick is ready to turn around and do it all again.
So away we go, 3 more days and I'll be home.
2,500 kilometres back to his home and family in Perth.
Give Sandy a ring as I'm leaving town so she knows she can start counting down. That wind's getting stronger, pushing me over a little bit.
In Central Australia, Slick's driven straight into the middle of a fierce desert dust storm.
Yeah, I could hardly see you too, until the last 50 metres. Northbound truck just seen him, he's saying that he's come up from Adelaide. It's windy down south of the border, but no dust. All the dust is in the territory. We're only 150 kilometres from the border. This sort of dust gets rammed down into your air filters and clogs up your air filter. I reckon the weather's going to turn for the worst. I reckon we're going to come into rain tonight, I reckon.
With temperatures dropping fast, Slick's worried that rain could turn the Outback into a mud bath.
No heat on the windows. Normally, this time of the day, middle of the afternoon, these should be red hot. Bugger all heat on them, there's no heat in that sun. Might have to work hard through the mud, see what happens.
Slick is trying to get home to Perth in time for Christmas. But back at headquarters, Steve Graham has other plans.
Now, Kath, did I tell you that Grant's rung me?
No. What's happened?
We've got to get another triple into Alice Springs by Christmas.
A last-minute road train haul across the Outback has Slick's name on it.
All right, I'm going to talk to Steve.
I left a message for Slick to ring me, and I'm expecting him to ring me any minute. Slick's got 2,000 k's to go. That way, if I can meet him at Leonora, it is doable. But he's not going to be happy, and I don't think Sandy's going to be happy either.
Hello, how you going, mate?
Yeah, good, Slick, you?
Yeah, blowing a gale.
Are you sitting down, Slick? Sit down, mate.
We've got to get another triple in there by Christmas, mate.
The new job adds almost 7,000 kilometres of driving before Slick can make it home.
I'm going to have to tell Sandy.
His chances of making Christmas suddenly don't look good.
Oh, how am I going to tell her?
I know that you know that
I wouldn't be springing it on you if it hadn't come out of the blue on me.
You've got 13 days
to do about 6,700 kilometres, mate.
I'll tell you what, if she takes it the wrong way, she'll be ringing you up straight away. You know that.
I know that. Sorry about that, Slick.
I'll talk to you in a while.
All right, no worries.
Righto, mate. Good on you.
Okay.
Slick's not happy.
Steve's loading right now. He's hoping to leave tomorrow. And, I mean, I'll be halfway across the desert tomorrow. And so I've got to go right across, meet him at around about Leonora, and come back again. And do everything that I've done here, find a backload, stack up, do it all again, and then go home. Skimmer me teeth, 2 days to spare. I cannot miss Christmas, that's family time. Any other day of the year is fine, I'll work. But Christmas, I just have to break it to my wife now. So I'm just gonna have a walk and try to think of how I'm gonna break it to her. All right. Why can't he cart it though? How you going, sweetheart?
Good, how are you?
Yeah, all right.
What's wrong?
I got a message to give Steve a call.
Oh, far out. What's happened?
I've got to come back to Alice Springs. I've got another triple to do to Alice.
Another week of leave without you?
About 10 days, sweetheart.
Okay.
10, 11 days, depending on the weather, of course.
All right, well, as long as you're safe.
Yeah, love. Okay. All right.
I love you.
Love you too, sweetheart.
Bye.
See ya.